In this video, I'm going to show you how to make your voice cut through the mix, be it background music, sound effects, or both, with some very simple sound mixing that anybody can do. I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because today is all about finessing your audio in post. What we will walk through today can be done in any software as long as it has EQ capabilities. But I'm a fan of Final Cut Pro, so we'll be using that in this video. Getting good sounding voice in videos has always been a struggle. I've never known what to look for in the audio mix. I just knew if it sounded good or not. And I have friends who do that professionally and make it seem easy. And I will share what I've learned so you can get to a good place fast in your sound mix. First and foremost, this video assumes that your audio was recorded well. I made a video about some best practices for recording audio. The link is in the description. What we are trying to do is to make sure that the voice and the music audio frequencies don't overlap too much, and that each has their own space to play in the frequency. It's about creating audio contrast. Think of it like this. It's like using the same color to design something. If the colors are too similar, it's hard to distinguish what is what. The same is true for audio frequencies. The usable voice frequency band ranges from about 300 Hertz to about 3400 Hertz. For males, typically it's a little bit lower on that scale, and for females, it's higher. And music can fall across an even wider range. And depending on the types of instruments used, the frequency can fall right where the voice lives. So the goal is to make sure that the voice has a priority in that frequency space with little interference in the intelligibility. So we'll cut the frequency out of the music where the voice is most prominent. First, once you've done your edit and all your audio is separated to its proper roles, dialogue, effects, and music, I would put them in the compound clip by pressing Option G. Then right-click on the compound clip and select Expand Audio Components. This is where we will do all the audio adjustments and mix for the dialogue, effects, and the music. This is Final Cut's way of making an audio bus. I would love if there was a way to apply these effects and controls to all the audio parameters to whole audio lanes. It would make this process so much easier. First, we'll deal with the music as a bass. Lower the volume so it's bouncing around negative 20 dB. Apply the channel EQ effect from the effects browser. Click on the icon to open up the parameters. We want to cut around the 1K mark, pull it down about minus 18 dB. We'll do a wide sweep cut for now and refine a little later. This is the area where the voice frequency tend to live. Before anything, I add a light vocal denoise to get rid of any background hiss that may be present in the audio. And doing this first ensures that any hiss won't get amplified with anything that we do next. First, add the compressor effect found in the audio levels effect panel. Simply, a compressor is used to compress a sound's dynamic range. That is, it makes the louder and quieter parts of the sound's performance closer to each other in the level. This is where I would check the input level to make sure it's not peaking. I would leave the threshold at around negative 20 dB. The threshold is the level that the signal needs to raise above in order for the compressor to begin to work. If the signal is too low or doesn't cross this threshold, the compressor will simply allow the signal to pass through unchanged. I set the ratio to 4:1, which is pretty good for the voice. The compression ratio determines how much gain reduction the compressor applies when the signal passes a threshold level. For example, the ratio 4:1 means that for every 4 decibels the signal raises above the threshold, the compressor will increase the output by 1 decibel. I generally leave the makeup as is, but the makeup gain parameter refers to the gain control at the output of the compressor. Compressors reduce the level of loudness signals. So after implementing compression, you usually end up with a quieter signal, and this is where the makeup brings that level back. But I turn on auto gain to do this for me with an output of 0 dB. I turn on the limiter. And the limiter takes compression to the extreme and provides more use in the mastering process during mixing. In fact, a limiter is a type of compressor with a really high ratio. And as the name suggests, limiting sets a limit or a ceiling for the output level. I set it to negative 3 dB. This ensures that nothing goes above that. And then I adjust the output to around negative 6 dB. Now add the channel EQ found in the audio EQ effect panel. This is where we'll make sure that it's only giving us the frequencies we want. What we want to look for is any resonance frequencies and remove them, like so. They have their purpose and place, but mostly they take way too long to set up to get the right shot, especially motorized sliders. There is a dedication to using these, usually pre-planning and understanding the limitations. I find them fantastic for product shots and for shots that are planned for them, where a shot has to be repeated over and over again for VFX layering or repeat takes. But for the most part, they too just sit in a case for when they are needed, which isn't that regularly. And don't even get me started on the travel size ones, because majority of the time, they just stay in the backpack. Instead, I've always found more success with the portal rail, like this one from Rig Wheels. Once it's set up, you test your shot. What I typically listen for is that humming or singing sound and try to reduce it. And I just look for very noticeable ones and cut them out by 3 to 5 dB. And I only do this for the big distracting frequencies. And each voice and location produces different resonance. Then I would bump up the overall high end to give more presence overall. Next, I would add the de-esser. De-essing is the process of attenuating or reducing sibilance, or the harsh high frequency sounds that come from dialogue or vocals using letters like S, F, X, SH, and the soft Cs. It's an often necessary process when mixing audio, but it's rarely easy, especially if you're just getting started. I still find it a bit tricky, and I generally just check the monitor to see what it's picking up and just leave it. They have their purpose in place, but mostly they take way too long to set up to get the right shot, especially motorized sliders. And with all these effects, you can save presets if you're working with the same voice and location to get to a starting point really quickly. And right after this, I would listen to both the music and the voice and see how they play together and adjust the volumes accordingly to make sure that it feels balanced overall. Understanding the limitations. I find them fantastic for product shots and for shots that are planned for them, where a shot has to be. And at this point, you're good to go with your mix with the built-in tools. But if you're anything like me, there has to be a simpler and streamlined way to make sure that the voice sounds good. This is where some of my few favorite plugins come in handy. And I will be honest, I was very hesitant at first because I am not an audio engineer or an audio guy at all. So plugins were the last thing on my mind until a friend recommended that I would download the free trial. And I've been using Acusonus since Era 4 to help make the audio editing process a lot easier overall. But they reached out recently to see if I wanted to try out what was new in Era 5. They have really tried to take the complexity out of audio editing and mixing with some pretty cool tools to tackle most audio issues with a few clicks that most people face. This includes a denoiser, a de-esser, a plosive remover, which reduces those hard P's and F sounds when you're too close to a mic, voice leveler, which is in essence a normalized function to bring up lower end sound up to be closer to the higher end volume. But with this effect, I found that you have to be careful because it can bring up background noise. So you have to make sure that you're recording in a quiet place or add a denoiser before adding the voice leveler. There's also mouth declicker and my two favorite, the voice deepener and voice audio EQ. I find myself using the voice audio EQ very often as it does about 90% of all the stuff that I showed you before, but with a very simple control. Just move it around until you find the sound that best suits what you're looking for. First, you find a clean 5-second section with the voice, click the learn button, let it analyze with its built-in AI, and when it's done, you want it a bit more airy, do you want more clarity or more body? And just tweak the position and the intensity to your liking and you're good to go.
Today, we're going to talk about the best ice cream place in town. I've always felt that a good gelato place was missing around here, but it's finally here and it's amazing.
Sometimes though, I'll double up the voice layer and add auto voice EQ to one and leave the other one clean, or maybe add a little bit of denoise and just blend the two layers together because sometimes I find the effect still a bit too intense. I also like using the voice deepener because this is really handy depending on the mic that you record with. It helps bring back some of that low end that can be lost with mics that lean towards the high end pickup. They also have a cool voice changer plugin that has some pretty fun effects. With presets, you can transform regular voices into any character you can imagine. There are three types of profiles that you can apply: the character, the environment, and effect. By using or combining any of these profiles, you can make creative scenarios out of otherwise normal voices. Both Era 5 and Voice Changer work on Windows and Mac in most NLEs and audio editors. There's a link in the description for a free trial for both Era 5 and Voice Changer. They also have a monthly subscription or a perpetual license if that's the way you want to go. There's also a link in the description for my free Final Cut preset that I used in this video for you to use as a starting point in your workflow. If you found this video helpful, here's a playlist of more Final Cut tips and tricks. And I do a live stream on my second channel where I do deep dives on the creative process and discuss freelancer financials. As always, thanks for watching. Give this video a big thumbs up. Subscribe. I'm Rafael. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.